This week on Ground Level
Welcome to Ground Level Perspective.
Writer, producer, director, Bentley Calhoun.
When it was all a dream, we used to read Word Up magazine. Salt and pepper and Heavy D up in the limousine, and she was in the limousine with him, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, welcome back to Ground Level Perspective. Kymm Wilson, Ground Level Perspective.
Ground Level Perspective. That's it, man.
Let's go back to how it all started and where the vision came from. Oh, we go way back. I'm just going to let you know how far we go back.
No.
What?
My name is Kymm Wilson. Welcome to Ground Level Perspective. This is my opinion, and I'm entitled to it.
I'm just saying that's how it rolls. What's up, y'all? Kymm Wilson, Ground Level Perspective. We at Bentley Cal Evans' house. We're about to go do a quick interview. VIP entrance only. That's how we do it. Make sure y'all get a glimpse of the whole house. And then, well, no, we're saying MTV. So you follow us.
We can check it out, though.
Exactly.
What's up, Almond Brown?
From the creative mind that brought you The Jamie Foxx Show and Martin, Bentley Kyle Evans.
Here it is, Ground Level Perspective. My name is Kymm Wilson. We're sitting here with Mr. Bentley Kyle Evans. I even like the name. The name just sounds tight. And we had a great conversation before the show, but I want to make sure everybody captures that. So let's start at the beginning, man. Let's talk about your start and where you're from first.
Well, you know, first and foremost, I'm born in Oakland, California.
Did you hear that?
Oaktown.
I'm just saying.
Oaktown, stand up.
Exactly.
So I'm from, I'm born in the O.
Right.
My parents both raised in Oakland and everything, mm-hmm. Richmond and Oakland.
Right.
But I grew up here in L.A., so,
right.
I claim the O.
Have to.
But I grew up here in L.A.
Exactly,
of course. Did all my school time here and everything,
right.
So yeah.
So you started the school and all that stuff out here, high school. Where'd you go to high school out here?
I went to Westchester High School.
Okay.
Westchester put some cats on the map. let's see who went to Westchester. Nia Long was there.
Right.
Regina King was there.
Nice.
Karen White was there.
Right.
Kenny Norton Jr. from the 49ers was there.
Right.
Who else was at Westchester when I was there? Came through there. A lot of people in the NBA. Trevor Ariza, a lot of cats came out of Westchester. So we did it. We did it big.
That's what I'm talking about, man. Nah, but I want to talk about some of the cool stuff that you've done before and all the stuff that you got coming up. So if we can go backwards towards a little bit, and we talk about your resume a little bit and how you got started in this business.
Yeah,
let's start there.
Well, we could do that. I mean, here's the deal. I was sitting up thinking this morning. I was just, shaving. I was in the mirror, and I said, you know what? I have accomplished a lot of things.
Mm.
And in this business, I've accomplished, acting professionally.
Right.
Writing professionally, producing professionally.
Mm-hmm.
And now directing professionally. I direct my own show.
Mm-hmm.
And, I was able to, do all of those things at a professional level. So, starting out as an actor, I started out with the whole Robert Townsend crew when they did the Hollywood Shuffle. You remember that?
Nice. He spent all his money on credit cards.
Spent all his money on credit cards. And believe me, I spent some of that money.
Because
we were getting donuts and running up and down the street. It was all done independently.
Right.
But,
I remember that.
Yeah, and Robert doesn't get the credit, being one of the first independent pioneers in this, new generation of film and television making.
Sure.
But, I started out with him. And that led me to work with the Wayans family, with Keenan Ivory Wayans, Damon Wayans, Sean and Marlon Wayans, who are my very close dear friends.
Mm-hmm.
And so I worked with them on several projects, I'ma Get You Sucker. And then after
the fish shoes.
Yeah, the fish shoes. I was standing right there when that scene was shot. I was right there, right in mid-Wilshire area.
Yeah.
So I've seen a lot of classic Black Hollywood events take place right in front of my eyes. Very well connected with a lot of those cats. And, you know, so I did the acting thing. You know, I worked with a lot of people, man, during my acting stint, you know, from, you know, James Earl Jones to...
Oh, that's my favorite.
Yeah. James Earl Jones told me in the middle of a scene I was doing, he told me, "That's horrible. Let's go outside. I want to talk to you." And he scared, you know, he scared the hell out of me, man, because this is Darth Vader talking to you, you know what I'm saying?
Here you go.
And he's, you know, he's chopping it up with me, and he's telling me, you know, it's not that you're a bad actor.
Right.
You're just not making a good choice. Oh. So he told me, "Who's your favorite ball player?" And I said, "Well, Magic Johnson's my favorite ball player." Right. He said, "Well, you need to channel that energy." Oh. And then when I went back in, I did this scene, and man, it came off the page, and he looked at me and went like that. But you know, and that was young in my career. That was early on and everything. But it was very good advice. And I worked with Bernie Casey, Jim Brown, Isaac Hayes, Eric LaSalle, Martin Lawrence. I did episodes of Doogie Howser. I did episode of Family Matters with Urkel and all that kind of stuff.
Oh, nice!
I mean, lot of stuff, man. I worked with a lot of people when they were on the brink of their rise and everything, and that was my acting experience. I never really wanted to be an actor. Mm-hmm. I thought it was a good idea, but I never really wanted it.
Good idea.
Good idea. I never really wanted that. What I wanted was, I was, when I was about 15 years old, I saw that, I knew that I wasn't an athlete, although I had the size.
Right.
I knew that my scholastic ability was only gonna take me so far because I didn't have the patience for it.
Right.
But I knew when I saw filmmaking, that's what I wanted to be. I was a TV kid, man. I grew up watching TV.
Exactly. Especially when we only had 3 channels back then.
We only had 3 channels. Yeah, CBS, yes, NBC, ABC. And ABC.
Right. We knew about Fantasy Island. Yeah.
Fantasy, I love both. No doubt. No doubt. The Waltons.
Happy
Days. You know, it's a good time. You know the ones.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
You know,
yeah,
so yeah, yeah. I imagined myself being in that somehow, you know, right, being in that industry, but acting wasn't it. What did happen, which was kind of crazy, was that Martin Lawrence, and when he got his deal to do his show, Martin said, "Hey man, what you want to do? We partners and everything. What you want to do?" I said, "Man, you know what? I want to write. If you give me that opportunity to write, man, you all right." And I said, "I do. Read this."
Yeah.
I showed him some stuff that I had written, and Martin called me up the next day, true story, and said, "Bet, you doing this with me.
Wow.
Whatever I do with this show, whatever happens with it, you going for the ride."
When we come back, we're going to make sure we talk about exactly what he's doing now, all the kind of stuff that he's got coming up. Man, he's been a part of so much, and he got his hands in so many pots. We want to make sure we at least talk about one of those pots and show all the good stuff that he's doing. Once again, Kymm Wilson, Ground Level Perspective. We'll be back in a minute. Hey, what's going on again? Kymm Wilson, we back in central location. I ain't gonna tell you where it is. Special VIP entrance, only where we go. Ground Level Perspective. We got Bentley Cal Evans on the show. What I'm hearing from you, more than anything, you just took the time to start somewhere.
Yeah.
You took the time to write the script that you said, the 2 scripts, and it didn't go where you wanted to go. But out of that, Martin Lawrence. And from Martin Lawrence, it just tells me that you built great relationships.
Yeah, I mean, I started in the business in 1986. Mm-hmm. And through that experience, I have made great relationships with a lot of very talented and people that I consider to be very great people in this business.
Right.
And, you know, at the forefront of all that is, you know, Martin Lawrence. Me and Martin are thick as thieves. And
Alibaba, huh?
This dude is my dude. This is my dude, you
right.
know. Can't nobody say nothing bad about Martin. You know, they got to fight if we do, if they do.
That's what it comes down to.
That's what it comes down to, but because this guy saw something in me. He saw the talent that I may not have even known that I had myself, and he gave me a shot, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And so when somebody gives you a shot, you never forget them, you know what I mean? And so, I mean, I've worked with Will Smith, man. I've worked with Nick Cannon. I was very instrumental in discovering Nick Cannon and bringing him to the forefront.
Nice.
With a deal that I had with Warner Brothers Television, and me and Will produced his first first TV project. So, you know, I've got a lot of great relationships, established a lot of really good ones. You name it, Black Hollywood, if I don't know them, we're a phone call away.
Right. Yeah. Now I want to get, you know, let's talk about like Jamie Foxx show, and then some of the stuff that you're doing right now. Let's start with the Jamie Foxx show. How did that vision just start?
You know what, the Jamie Foxx show, man. Let's see. At the time I was working on the Martin show, and it was we were going into our final season of the Martin show, and Warner Brothers TV was interested in doing a overall development deal with me. So as soon as I got there to Warner Brothers, they gave me an office, set me up, put me in a nice little situation.
Nice.
I saw a list, and the list had all the talent that Warner Brothers had deals with, and I saw Jamie Foxx's name. And the first thing I could think of was Wanda.
Right.
First thing I could think of was, okay, young black comedian. I did that with Martin. I worked with him.
That formula
works. Right. I can do the same thing with Jamie. And so, you know, I went over and told them that I wanted to work with Jamie. They put us in a room together, and you know, Jamie said, "You know what, man? It's a little late though, Ben. I'm already signed with another writer producer to do my show." And right. I left that meeting. I said, "Well, man, you know what? Maybe we'll do something down the line." I get a phone call before I could even get out of the valley. No, but I get a call from my agent and they say, "Man, you know, go back over there and meet with Jamie. He wants to talk to you again." So I turn around and go back, and he says, "You know what? I don't want to do that project with that other guy I was telling you about. You got something. Me and you the same age. We kind of, I think you feel my vision, you know, and I think
that's a great compliment.
It's the truth. We were right there in our late 20s. I think I was 29, 28, 29. And so he said, "You know what, let's play with this concept." So we came up with a concept, and it was actually Jamie's idea to do this hotel thing. I was like, "Man, you sing, let's do something with the voice." He said, no, "That's too easy, Let's do something with a hotel."
Right.
"I just want to do a hotel. Now, take that and come up with something." So
take that.
I took it and created these characters. And he was on the road at the time doing stand-up. And I was calling him going, "Hey, dude, let me fax you these pages. Let me know what you think."
Right.
He said, yeah, you got it. So when he got back, we went into Warner Brothers and we pitched it, man. We pitched it to Warner Brothers TV, then we took it over to a few different networks.
Right.
Yeah, and then we ended up going with the WB, new network. We figured we'd have more legs with a new network.
Yeah, of course. And we're a little more control of how you want to do things. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could see that.
So that was it. And then, you know, next thing I know, they're ordering 26 episodes or whatever, 22 episodes what it was. And we got on, and then we went all the way to 100.
Wow, yeah. That's excellent.
Michael Mann said, "Can you play a cab driver?" I said, "Come on, Mike, you know I do my thing." He said, "Well, can you not do your thing?" And so what I did was I linked onto a character by the name of Bentley Kyle Evans, who was my producer on my television show. Bentley was a nice guy, and he worked with some people that were not so nice, and he was able to work with them for 5-6 years. And never had a serious problem because he was able to maneuver. I said, "This is what Max needs to be."
This is Jamie Foxx. First of all, I want to say, if anyone is listening to Bentley Kyle Evans' voice, you are in the right place.
What are you doing now?
So right now,
yeah,
I am currently executive producing a new show called Love That Girl, starring Tatiana Ali. It's on Monday nights at 9 o'clock.
9 o'clock
on TV One.
On TV One.
It's TV One's very first original scripted sitcom. So it's history in the fact that it's never been done like this before. It's a black owned production company, my company, Bent Outta Shape Productions, and we sold a show directly to TV One. So it's a black company doing business with a black company. And
nice.
That hasn't been done in the history of TV. Not even with Tyler Perry, what he's doing. And although I applaud his efforts and everything that he's doing as well.
Right. Sure.
But what we've done on a smaller scale that's going to be is what I consider to be just as big. We were able to keep it, you know, within the whole black thing. You know, we were able to do that. Not that that's super important.
No, that is super important because you gotta look at the example that you're setting out.
Yeah.
Look at what you're creating a whole new vision, kind of like when Obama became president.
Right.
You're shifting thought processes.
Yep.
And when you shift thought process, you don't know what seeds are being planted from that.
No, you don't.
Yeah, because you're gonna look up one day and be like, "Well, we did this now because we took that chance."
Yeah.
Now look at what it's become.
And it could become something, it can become something so much bigger than what we set out to do.
Mm-hmm.
It's a dream. It's you know, when you dream sometimes and you wake up and mm-hmm. then you try to go back and catch that same dream. You can't.
but it
becomes a bigger dream.
It becomes a bigger dream. It becomes connected to something else.
Yeah.
But I like the fact that you've opened the door for so many people. And now you're working with Love That Girl.
Love That Girl, starring Tatiana Ali.
And you're opening more doors.
Opening up more doors and creating opportunities that don't exist in Hollywood at this point. We're the only African-American themed sitcom shooting in Hollywood. But I chose to stay in Cali and in Hollywood because this is the Mecca. This is where it is.
This is it.
And so we're employing a lot of people again. And I feel really blessed to be in that position to do that.
This Kymm Wilson, Ground Level Perspective, sitting here with Mr. Evans, man. And we are going to be back in a minute. Right back. Kymm Wilson, Ground Level Perspective. We over here kicking with Bentley Cal Evans. He is allowing us to come through and see his whole hookup for today. And we're going to find out a little later on how he run his whole operation.
Well, you're gonna see a little bit of that. A lot of that, you know, is the magic that you keep bottled up, you know what I'm saying? You don't want to give it all away, you know what I'm saying? Because then, you know what I'm saying?
You can't give it all away.
You can't give it all away, you know what I'm saying? Because the game is to be sold and not to be told.
Oh, exactly. And we are here just to make sure you can get a tad bit so y'all can buy it. That's what I'm talking about.
Yep, Love That Girl.
I'm giving it to her. Beautiful.
When it was all a dream, we used to read Word Up magazine. Salt and Pepper and Heavy D up in the limousine, and she was in the limousine with him, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, nobody gets this normal job. I mean, it's just cool being around all these, you know, people who inspire me to do better in school and, you know, want to act. And it's really cool to see him like do his thing, cause like not many people get to see their parents like do things like this and work on shows.
Are you still running that damn thing, man? Get that shit off my face, man.
Man, I know it's the end of the day, man. You had a lot today. I got a chance to see you in action, and seeing you in action was motivating for me. As I sat there and watched you work with 45 people on your set, how do you do your operation to make it so successful?
45 of them was just family members. No, man, you know, it's a process, man. You know, we make it work. You know, you surround yourself with great people. You know, you gotta be smart enough to realize you ain't that smart. So you surround yourself with great people, great minds, and that can do their jobs better than you could ever imagine. And you just gotta trust that they're gonna get it done, and in most cases they do. So you know, you got a great deal of people a majority of the people I've been working with for many, many years. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people came from the Warner Brothers days with me from the Jamie Foxx show.
Mm-hmm.
Some even go back as far as the Martin show back in 1992.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you just kind of know what they do and let them, as Jamie Foxx would say, let them do what they do.
Well, let's talk about this too, man, because there's some intricate details that went on, because you got three different sets in one place.
Mm-hmm.
And just people moving around, getting set ups. I mean, who gives the directions on all of that?
Realistically, it all comes from me.
Mm-hmm.
But it just goes through different channels. It goes through different department heads.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you got a prop master. So who's over the prop department? You have a set designer who's over the sets. You have electric, you know, grip and electric.
Mm-hmm.
And a DP that's over them. You have, the sound department. Everything runs through that department head. Hair and makeup, everything runs through their department heads. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like their heads of states.
Ah, exactly.
And I'm the president.
Exactly. Why not, Mr. Obama?
You know, I don't know about that.
Yeah, but I know what you mean, though.
Yeah, it's a work in progress,
mm-hmm.
and I love it. I don't know anything else. You know, as long as I'm having fun, it's not work. Mm-hmm. Every day when I'm here, I realize
I'm blessed to be in this position, mm-hmm. to do what you love to do.
Oh yeah.
And get a check for it.
Oh yeah.
It's cool.
I'm on my way, ground level perspective.
No question.
That's what I like, man. Let's talk about some of the actors and actresses that are part of the show.
Well, I mean, you know, where should I start? Should we start with the top? Tatiana Ali.
There it is.
Tat's great. You know, she's a great actress, great person to work with, very patient. She takes really, really good direction, but not just taking direction, she gives a really great performance. But I mean, that goes back to her days of on the Fresh Prince.
She's Fresh Prince, yeah. You know. Hey, I tell you what, just watching her do her thing today, I was like, wow, she looks nice.
Well, she's not a little girl no more.
Not at all.
Definitely, she's a woman now.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, she's
a good looking one.
Yeah, you know, she ain't bad to look at.
Of course.
But extremely professional. And,
very.
And, you know, she's producing, her and her sister Anastasia are producing on the show as well. Mm-hmm. And, you know, just a pleasure to be around. And, I mean, Phil Morris, you got a chance to see him do his...
Yeah, I like Phil.
Man, look, Phil been in the game for a long time. We go way back. His father was one of the first blacks on television. His father starred in Mission Impossible, the great Greg Morris.
Oh, that's that dude.
Oh, yeah, no question.
See, I got to do some more research.
You better research that, man. Professional homie, man.
I should have known that, you know what I'm saying, the chin. I should have seen
it. It's all up in the chin, you know, and up in here. It's something up in here.
Something up in here.
You know.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the brothers with no mustaches. It's something up in there. You one of them, you know what I'm saying?
I'll be trying, you know, I'm trying to get rid of that, but.
Yeah, you know, you got you know, Alfonso McCauley, who's a great find.
Oh, yeah.
Meaning that Alfonso is, he's a comedian. He's doing stand-up, but he's just got that it factor.
Oh yeah.
Some people, you just see it and you just go like this, he got it. And speaking of that, you know, Bresha Webb, who wasn't here today, but she plays the character I'm Unique, got that it thing going on.
All her different hairstyles.
All the different hairstyles, makeup, different moods and everything, but she's laugh out loud funny. She represents the hood. She represents that hood chick.
Oh yeah, exactly.
Well, you gotta have her. You know, it's a diverse group of individuals, man. We represent black, white, Latino, straight, gay.
Right.
We ain't prejudiced.
Exactly.
You know, but you know, nobody's immune from getting hit either. You know, we clown everybody.
Oh, everybody.
Yeah.
I saw that on the set.
Okay, here we go. Big energy, having fun, feel, and action.
Man, Bentley Cal Evans is doing it, and we are on set. This cat from Oakland, Kymm Wilson. Ah, look at that. Well, I can tell you right now, based off what I saw today, mm-hmm. the set, all of this stuff that you worked out, you want it.
I want it.
Oh, yeah.
I want it.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
I want it.
Yeah.
I want the success. Mm-hmm. I want the power. Mm-hmm. I want the respect.
Yeah.
I want the paper.
Oh.
But you know what, more important than all of that?
Mm-hmm.
I just want happiness, man. More important than all of it.
That's what I'm talking about, a girl level perspective. Bentley Cal Evans doing his thing on the set of Love That Girl. And GLP is in the house as ground level perspective here because we get to be here because of Bentley Cal Evans. Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
My dog. I hope y'all got what you needed.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir.
That's it. Kymm Wilson, the professional homie, and we are out to the next show. Catch us on the next one.
That's the professional homie.
Next week on Ground Level Perspective, multi-platinum artist producer Dwayne Wiggins.
For folks like yourselves, you know, documenting and making sure that the voice is heard, then we, you know, we wouldn't be here. So
next week on Ground Level Perspective.
No.
What?
My name is Kymm Wilson.
Welcome to Ground Level Perspective. This is my opinion, and I'm entitled to it.